Phelps, Bukowski, you have a new case. Two women, possible drink drive.
How is that a case?
The broad says she was doped and that somebody tried to kill her.
Where did this take place?
That's the bit you're gonna love. Right across the street.
What?
A Chevy Styline took a nosedive off the escarpment, fetched up underneath a Cola King billboard. Up to it, boys. We got bad guys to catch.
Parker or Green? I don't know who'd be worse.
See you later, fellas. Try not to work too hard.
Look at you, Bampton with the boy. Tear to my eye watching my caterpillar grow wings.
I'm just trying to fit in.
Educated, hardworking, straight as an arrow. I break to you, Cole, but you'll never fit in at Central.
Her face looks familiar.
Well, that's June Ballard, Tarzan's sister, Beast of the Amazon. She's married to Guy McAfee. The captain has moved to Vegas now, but the two of them still have juice.
Phelps, traffic.
Detective Phelps. Hey, Bukowski. Long time no see.
You could have called this in by megaphone, Enrique. Phelps, this is Enrique Gonzalez. Enrique was a pretty decent middleweight.
What do we have, Gonzalez?
Broad drives right through the empty lot and off the side of the escarpment. Her story is that a movie producer doped her and her friend and sent the car over the cliff.
Was anyone hurt?
Driver's beat up. Not too bad, considering. If she hadn't hit that billboard, we'd be scraping both of them off the pavement. Passenger's a Jessica Hamilton. She's just a kid. She's pretty knocked around.
Kid gonna be all right?
I think so. They've taken her to central receiving. If you want to take a look around, stall the ambulance.
Thanks. Do that.
If you're looking for the coroner, he's down by the crash site.
This ain't the red carpet, so get out of my lens.
You'll want to see this, Phelps. There, laid out on the trunk. And that isn't even the best part.
Looks like they're lucky they weren't more badly injured.
Must have been unconscious. Being relaxed tends to lessen the soft tissue damage.
They've been torn off. Where did you find them?
They were stuffed in the young lady's handbag. I'll run a trace for semen when I get back to the lab.
She's a long way from home. Drunk driver?
Maybe not.
How so?
Well, a head I found without a body piqued my interest. See what you think.
Alas, poor Yorick. I knew him, Horatio. Is it real?
No. I think it's supposed to be a replica of an Indian shrunken head. It's some kind of curio or movie prop. See the casting marks?
What's it made from?
Plaster of Paris would be my first guess, then painted.
So we can rule out the murder angle?
No, you can rule that in. That thing was wedging the accelerator to the floor. Whoever did it wanted these women dead.
How does someone manage to tip their ride straight off a cliff? If the driver's in a fit state, we should ask.
Mrs. McAfee, we would like to ask you a few questions, if that's okay.
I prefer to use my maiden name, June Ballard. You might be familiar with some of my work.
Can you tell us what happened here?
You're kind of cute for a cop. maybe a bit on the serious side.
What about me, June? I'm a big fan of
you?
Beast of...
I don't like. Keep out of this.
We understand that you're still suffering from the effects of the accident, Mrs. McAfee. The officer says that you claimed that you were drugged. Who did this to you?
That rat slipped us a Mickey Finn. It's no wonder I feel so dopey. I can't remember.
It's a serious offense to withhold information from the police during a criminal investigation, madam.
I told you to call me June. You're making me feel like an old lady. And don't bother your handsome head about this. My husband will settle the score with Mark Bishop.
What can you tell us about the passenger in your car?
Jessica Hamilton. Poor Jessica. It's been a rough day for her. She's desperate to break into movies. What more can I say?
I think you're lying, Mrs. McAfee. I think something happened to Jessica yesterday before the crash.
I'm offended, Sunshine. Do you have any proof?
Miss Hamilton's underwear were physically torn from her body.
She wanted to go to a casting. I took her to a casting. Whatever happened after that is between her and Mark Bishop.
We found a shrunken head. It was used to tamper with your car.
You see, I normally don't drive off cliffs. The last thing I remember is getting behind the wheel.
It's obviously some kind of movie prop. You must know where it came from.
In case you hadn't noticed, I am the talent. And the talent doesn't deal with props or sets or any of that kind of stuff. Why don't you ask Mark Bishop which prop house he uses?
You mentioned a Mark Bishop. You think he might have had something to do with this?
He is a movie producer. As for his involvement, you just leave it to me and my husband to worry about.
I want to know what happened between you two that made him want to commit a double murder.
Bishop offered me a part in his picture. Then he withdrew it. Fact is, we had a deal. I pressed him on it. This is where I end up.
Mrs. McAfee, I think it would be in everyone's best interest if you accompanied Patrolman Gonzalez back to the receiving hospital.
I'm going to be okay. These guys can take me home after my lawyer and I have talked to the news hounds.
Mrs. McAfee, you are still under the influence of narcotics, and you're likely to go into shock once the drugs wear off.
And I thought you were a heel. It's nice of you to be concerned.
I think we're good here. Let's go see what we can shake out of the kid.
I knew it wasn't safe around here anymore.
This is awful. Just awful.
You know the way. You can drive.
Fine. Where are we headed?
KGPL to car 11K, 11 King. The car crash victim has regained consciousness at Central Receiving Hospital.
Hello, Detective Phelps, here to interview a Jessica Hamilton.
Jessica Hamilton? Oh, yes. She's in the room, right behind you, Detective.
You can't hold me here. No.
Feeling better since this morning, Jessica?
I don't need to be manhandled by a doctor. I need my lawyer.
My head still feels swimmy.
Where is the telephone? Do you know who I am?
Hello, Jessica. My name is Cole Phelps. I'm a policeman. I'd like to talk to you about your accident, if that's okay.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell me what you remember about the crash?
It's all kind of fuzzy. I remember waking up here. Nothing happened yesterday.
Tell the truth, Jessica. Why the big cover-up?
I'm not lying to you.
We found your underwear and your handbag, Jessica. You need to tell us what happened.
The doctor told me what happened. I didn't want that. I just wanted to be a star, to be in movies. I told Juni what happened, and she told me to toughen up. That was the price of stardom.
Did she now, cold-hearted bitch?
It's not Juni's fault. It's not my first time. I had a boyfriend back home, but my father found out about him.
Even if you consented, Jessica, you're still underage. We need to get in touch with your parents, Jessica, to tell them what has happened.
Oh, you don't need to worry them. They sent me along to stay with Aunt June. They trust her to take care of me.
You're lying, Jessica. How are we going to make this right if you lie to us?
Please, detective, why would I lie to you?
Because you're a runaway, Jessica, and you don't have your parents' permission to be here. Now, do you want to tell me what really happened?
I went with Juni to this strange place. It's difficult to remember. Someone gave me a drink to calm my nerves, and then I felt faint. I think I must have passed out.
How did you meet Mr. Bishop?
Well, Juni is a big movie star. You probably know that. She's doing a new movie.
What's the story with Bishop and Mrs. McAfee? Why does he want the two of you dead?
That can't be true. Mr. Bishop seemed very happy today. I mean, yesterday.
And that's why he wedged a shrunken head against the accelerator pedal and punted the two of you over an escarpment?
I overheard Juni speaking to him on the phone a couple of times. Screaming, really. She can be very hard sometimes, Juni. But they seemed okay yesterday, like they worked it out.
I know what happened to you, Jessica. Where exactly did it take place?
Please, it's scary. It's really difficult to think of anything.
Jessica, I really need you to help me here.
I remember the mermaid.
Was it the mermaid in the movie too?
No, it was on the front of a building. We pulled up in front of the mermaid.
Thank you, Jessica. You've been a big help. Here's my card. If you think of anything or you need some help, just get in touch, okay?
Okay.
I think it might be a good idea if you went back home till you felt better, Jessica.
I couldn't do that, officer. What if I got the part and I wasn't there?
It's the tale of this town, Cole. Lambs that go willingly to slaughter. Who the hell is that?
Must be her lawyer. He certainly expedited her release.
I don't like it, Cole. Why is she in such a hurry? We should follow her. There she goes. Come on. Easy, Cole. Better back it off. She seems to have made a remarkably speedy recovery. Siren? It's the tale of this town, Cole. Lamb.
You've got a pretty funny idea of what keeping a low profile means, Phelps. Too close, Phelps. You're way too close.
She seems to have made a remarkably speedy recovery.
Hit the brakes, Cole.
Get in there and see what she's up to.
She wants a 5-star, goddamn one.
Baby? No, I don't want him taught a lesson. You know what I want. Well, then make someone else do it. You still know people out here, don't you? Then make some calls. I'm going to be very clear about this. You get this done, or I'm... Wilson's Hotel. Mr. Mark Bishop, that son of a bitch, lives in apartment 803. Sure, I got the film.
Can you drive to this one?
Do we know where we're going?
So what's the story? I'm guessing she didn't stop for light refreshments.
She made a call. Sounds like Mark Bishop has a heap of trouble headed his way. I've got an address. Wilson's Hotel, apartment 803.
Oh, shit. You better step on it.
If he's got any sense, he'll be as far away from home as possible.
If he had any sense, he wouldn't have tried bumping off Guy McAfee's wife in the first place. Or he'd have done the job properly. McAfee will break a fella's legs just for looking at his broad the wrong way.
What did you make of the kid? You believe her story? I'm Detective Phelps. We received a call about a domestic disturbance in apartment 803.
Oh, the detectives. Listen, Mrs. Bishop's pretty upset. Take the elevator and then left down the corridor. It's the last door on the right.
Sounds like we're about to make it a hat trick of hysterical female witnesses.
LAPD, ma'am. Are you in danger?
I'm all right now. You just missed them. Horrible, awful men.
Are you injured, Mrs.?
Mrs. Bishop. Gloria Bishop. Please, come in, officers. I'll just need to sit down for a moment. Forgive me.
That's perfectly normal, ma'am.
Just look at this mess!
We'll take a quick search of the premises, ma'am. You take a moment to gather your thoughts.
I will. Thank you, officer.
What do you have to do to earn $20,000?
Doesn't look like anything.
Presented to Mark. Great Wall of Babylon, a replica of a replica. Looks like the old movie set downtown. Like we found our mermaid. Who are these men in the picture?
My husband, Mark, and Marlon Hopgood. They work together on occasion. That's Hopgood's shop.
Those men, I think they work for Guy McAfee. Do you know the name?
No. Why should I?
June Ballard is married to Guy McAfee. Have you heard of her?
That slut. She's been badgering my husband for days.
Mrs. McAfee alleges that your husband tried to kill her and her friend last night. I think you should tell us what you know.
My husband's a movie producer. This has something to do with his new picture. He doesn't include me in his business.
June Ballard said she had a deal to be in his new picture.
Mark repeatedly told her no. He had Joan Leslie lined up for the role. That's how he got the finance. June made all kinds of threats. She was very rude to me.
You know June Ballard?
We were both on the same picture a few years back. That's how I met my husband.
Where can we find your husband, ma'am?
He told me he would be on set. That's all I know.
Either we find him or McAfee's people do, Mrs. Bishop. If you care for him, you should make sure that we find him first.
I do care for him. But I don't really know where he'd go if he were in trouble. Hopgood might know.
Why is your husband paying Lorna Hopgood $20,000?
Lorna? Marlon's ex-wife? Are you sure?
You're lying, Mrs. Bishop. It's some kind of payoff. You know exactly what the money is for and who it's getting paid to.
Do I? Would you like to prove that, Detective?
Your husband looks like he's being blackmailed. They obviously have something on him if he's prepared to kill to cover it up. Why is the payment going to Hopgood and not McAfee?
Lorna works at a check cashing place in Hollywood. You need to ask Hopgood why he needs that much money in cash.
Your husband was at a casting yesterday with a young girl?
Not that I know of. He told me he was looking at locations. The picture's been cast.
Jessica remembered a mermaid. The mermaid on the front of the prop store. You better come clean with me.
This is a sick town, Detective. Are you sure you really want to know? The truth is, my husband likes them young.
And you think that's okay?
I was 16 when I first met him. I thought he was a genius, a magician with film. I was 20 before I realized he was just a B-movie hack. But he's nothing compared to some of the monsters at these big studios. My guess is Ballard sacrificed her little friend. Happens to a lot of girls.
Your husband is in trouble. It could go easier for him if you were more helpful, Mrs. Bishop.
He's a big boy, Detective, and so are you. This is Hollywood. There's always a deal to be done.
Operator, give me R&I.
Putting you through now.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need a location on a silver screen prop store.
Just a moment. Silver screen props, corner 3rd and Figueroa.
Thank you.
An aging movie star, a wannabe starlet, and a movie producer's wife. They're finally rubbing shoulders with the almost rich and famous.
And from the stories they've given us, clearly none of them can act. You can drive.
All right. Where to?
Mrs. Bishop...
Phelps and Bukowski, LAPD. We are investigating the attempted murder of June Ballard and Jessica Hamilton.
Christ! I'm Marlon Hopgood. How can I help?
You hold castings here?
How'd you hear about that? I got a little soundstage out back.
Lead the way. Keep him here, Stefan. I'm gonna take a look around.
What's this got to do with me?
Don't try my patience, knucklehead.
Doping a 15-year-old kid and abusing her in a screen test. What is wrong with these people? Turn off the lights, Hopgood.
Why would I want to do that?
Humor him.
One-way mirrors. There's a room on the other side.
Huh. Well, well. Find a way into that peep den, Phelps. I'll stay here and keep our pervert company.
This is where you sprang from.
Jungle Drums, 8th and Francisco. Attention, Mark Bishop.
So what happened to the film of Hamilton's screen test? You ever do any work for Mark Bishop?
Mainly do work for the studios. RKO, Republic, Warner Brothers. So, yeah. When Bishop is doing work for a studio, yes.
When did you last see him?
Now I'm doing work for his next picture. Still pre-production, though. I haven't seen him around here in a while.
I know you're lying, Hopgood. Bishop was here, and you know exactly what he was doing and what he left lying around afterwards.
You come in here without a warrant, and now you start throwing your weight around?
A 15-year-old girl told me how she was drugged and molested at a casting house. I found the chloral hydrate in your drinks cabinet. You give me something or I will break your fucking jaw, Hopgood.
Bishop was here with June Ballard and the girl. A lot of producers and directors use this place. I'm not responsible for what goes on here.
McAfee's men are looking for Bishop. We need to find him first. Any idea where he might have gone to ground?
If he really tried to kill McAfee's wife, my advice to him would be to leave town.
You're delivering props to Jungle Drums on 8th Street?
Bishop is using that old rundown wreck of a set. That place is dangerous. But it might be a good spot to hide.
What's the deal with you and June Ballard?
Look, buddy, I make props. I hardly ever meet the talent unless it's something tailor-made for them, like a sword or something.
You and Ballard are blackmailing Bishop. That's why he cracked.
You got nothing on me. My hands are clean on this.
Enough. I've been in your peep room, Hopgood. I've seen your smut pictures and the camera setup. You made a movie of Jessica. I found the canister.
The deal is I get to sell the movies to burlesque houses and private collectors. These movie guys love seeing their cocks on screen, but part of the arrangement is I never film their faces. June had me film Bishop, and then she kept the movie for insurance. He went apeshit when he realized his face was front and center.
Who has the film now?
Who else? McAfee.
Ballard had what she wanted. Where does the money come into it?
What money?
Enough of the lies.
I told you, I get my cut selling dirty movies.
Your ex was getting 20 large from Bishop.
If I wanted to skim 20 from Bishop, we'd do it through the movie budget. June said she'd sell him the film once the movie had wrapped, but Guy wanted cash. He's in a cash-only business. You think I had a choice in this?
That's all for now, Hopgood. We're taking you in.
Phelps! Roy Earle, add vice. Hold on a moment. This is clearly a vice case. Have you been roughing up my informant?
Hopgood is a vice informer?
Yes, he is, Phelps, and a very important one. Look at that mug. Have you been upsetting these two officers, Marlon?
So we just drop it?
You do if you know what's good for you. You need to catch the movie producer before an angry husband does, from what I'm hearing.
I'll be making a full report to the captain, detective.
You do that, kid. We're all very impressed with you. Let it slide, Cole. Let's get out of here.
Detectives!
Johnny Goldberg, you work for Mickey C.
That's right, detectives.
You wouldn't happen to know the guys who roughed up Mrs. Bishop earlier today by any chance?
No, no, not us. We don't do that kind of thing. It's the husband we'd like to talk to.
This is a police matter. You don't want to be taken in for obstruction of justice, do you, boys?
You could try the obstruction rap, but it won't stick. We can...
I don't think they like you! Can't take the shot from here, Cole.
They really don't want anybody getting to Bishop before they do.
Lay into his wheel arches. Come on. I'll try for the tires. Keep your foot down.
We need to lose those fools, Phelps.
Phelps? Enough games, Phelps. Take this guy out.
Make a move. We're sitting ducks here.
Let's see him chase us now. Onto the movie set, Phelps. Let's roll.
Oh, Christ. And they say working traffic is like watching paint dry.
You know how to piss people off, Bukowski.
Hey, if they're prepared to gun down cops in broad daylight, McAfee really means business.
Seems like we're the only ones who want Bishop alive.
I have a good mind just to let him go work on the son of a bitch. I'm about done putting my life on the line to protect some child molester.
That's our job.
You can drive. And where exactly are we going?
Get him, Phelps. I'll cover the exit.
Mark Bishop, stop! LAPD!
Calling KGPL, requesting assistance at 8th and Francisco, the abandoned movie set. My partner is pursuing suspect on foot. Code 3, KGPL.
We're trying to help you, Bishop. This is all a big mistake. Us or McAfee's boys, your choice.
I didn't do anything.
Get the hell out of here, you goddamn maniac.
Bishop, that's enough.
That girl made it all up.
Don't make this any harder on yourself, Bishop.
It's June Ballard! She's blackmailing me!
Hands in the air, Bishop! Move another...
Christ, detectives are trying to kill me!
Last chance to back the hell down!
I'm gonna put holes in you, asshole!
Way.
McAfee doesn't make the rules. You hear me?
Kill them, for God's sake! I don't want to die!
There's no way out of here. I thought you said you knew where you were going.
We have to jump for it.
LAPD, you're making a big mistake.
This way.
God, they're everywhere.
Hopeless.
How about the door, asshole?
Is this really the best McCaffrey's got?
Clever, asshole.
I'm gonna find me out of here.
We're in a war zone.
Stand. Wait.
I'll kill every last one of you if I have to.
For the love of God, how many are there?
Hopeless.
There's a ladder leading to the ground. I should have known that bitch was trouble.
At the base of the elephant column. They're full of gasoline. Shoot them, quickly!
Follow me. We need to get him to the car.
LAPD, you're making a big mistake.
Now this...
It was my only